My colleague Donald Casper and I showed that the design of these viruses could be explained in terms of a generalization of icosahedral symmetry that allows identical units to be related to each other in a quasi-equivalent way, with a small measure of internal flexibility. We enumerated all the possible designs, which have similarities to the geodesic domes designed by the architect R. Buckminster Fuller. However, whereas Fuller's domes have to be assembled following a fairly elaborate code, the design of the virus shell allows it to build itself. Klug's description once again reveals a manifest truth. There is a sensitive planning and a perfect structure, even in viruses, regarded by scientists as one of the simplest and smallest living things. This structure is a great deal more successful than and superior to those of Buckminster Fuller, one of the world's most eminent architects. The dodecahedron and icosahedron also appear in the silica skeletons of radiolarians, single-celled marine organisms. Structures based on these two geometric shapes, like the regular dodecahedron with feet-like structures protruding from each corner, and the various formations on their surfaces, make up the varying beautiful bodies of the radiolarians. The golden ratio also manifests itself in crystal structures. Most of these are in structures too minute to be seen with the naked eye. Yet you can see the golden ratio in snowflakes, the various long and short variations and protrusions that comprise the snowflake. All yield the golden ratio. You encounter Fibonacci series and the golden ratio in fields that fall under the sphere of physics. When a light is held over two contiguous layers of glass, one part of that light passes through, one part is absorbed, and the rest is reflected. What happens is a multiple reflection. The number of paths taken by the ray inside the glass, before it emerges again, depends on the number of reflections it is subjected to. In conclusion, when we determine the number of rays that re-emerge, we find that they are compatible with the Fibonacci numbers. The fact that a great many unconnected animate or inanimate structures in nature are shaped according to a specific mathematical formula is one of the clearest proofs that these have been specially created. The golden ratio is an aesthetic rule well known and applied by artists. Works of art based on that ratio represent aesthetic perfection. Plants, galaxies, microorganisms, crystals, and living things created according to this rule, imitated by artists, are all examples of God's superior artistry. God reveals in the Quran that He has created all things with a measure. Some of these verses read, God has appointed a measure for all things. Everything has its measure with Him.